Hello everyone, welcome back to the Aspen Tech channel. And in our today's video, we are moving to an advanced equipment in Aspen Plus, which is multi-stream heat exchanger. So far in the exchangers tab, we have seen MHEX and heater. That heater was used for both heating and cooling purposes, and MHEX was a simple heat exchanger which deals with one inlet stream of hot and one inlet stream of cold, or we can say two inlet streams and two outlet streams, one hot and one cold. While if you come to the multi-stream heat exchanger, it can handle multiple hot and cold streams. Like you can see in this diagram that the red lines show the hot stream and the green line shows the cold stream. Now you can see there are two hot streams which are being sent to this multi-stream heat exchanger, and there is only one cold stream. This is just an example. There could be more than one cold stream, there could be more than two even hot streams, there could be five, six, seven, in fact too many number of hot and cold streams in this block. So this is a detailed block which helps you in analyzing the different conditions. This block or this multi-stream heat exchanger is extremely useful when you are doing simulations of air separation processes where you have to take air to the cryogenic temperatures, and accordingly you have to exchange heat with the products like nitrogen, oxygen, etc. Or in the LNG regasification process, this multi-stream heat exchanger, this block is very useful. Similarly, for other equipments, for other auxiliaries, it is also suitable, because instead of using MHEX or multiple MHEX in series or in parallel, we can use a simple multi-stream heat exchanger block and we can perform our task. Now in this case, the philosophy is that obviously you have to specify all the inlet streams, and for outlet streams, first you need to specify the connections. For example, F6 is the outlet stream and its inlet stream was F5. F1 is the inlet stream and corresponding outlet stream is F3. So you have to specify these, and then you have to specify some operating specification, which could be temperature, which could be vapor fraction and so on, which we will see once we move to the Aspen Plus. And accordingly, you have to specify best practices to either specify the hot specifications of outlet or cold specifications of outlet. But in some cases, you can specify both. However, like you can see, there are three outlet streams. So you can specify a maximum of two outlet, obviously, because you have to compute the third one, or accordingly, you can specify this F4 and F3, F6 will be computed, or you can specify F3, F6 and then you can calculate the value of F4. So this is the overall philosophy of this, and this is a very, very simple representation. But in our upcoming video after that, we will take more complex process and we will simulate it. So for the streams data, that we have two hot streams which are coming to the process. Both are at the temperature of 50 degree centigrade, pressure of 2 bar, molar flow rate of 100 kg mole per hour, and mole fraction of methane. So both streams are methane streams at 50 degree centigrade, 2 bar, 100 kg mole per hour. And the cold inlet stream is a water stream at a flow rate of 1000 kg mole per hour, pressure of 2 bar, and temperature of 25 degree centigrade. And we have been given the block information that there is a pressure drop of 0.1 bar at hot side, 0.2 bar at cold side. It means for both hot streams, they do have a pressure drop of 0.1, 0.1, and for cold stream, which is one only, the pressure drop is of 0.2 bar, and the outlet temperature for both hot streams is 30 degree centigrade. So accordingly, the outlet temperature of the cold stream will be computed in this process. So let's quickly move to the Aspen Plus. First, we will enter the components methane and water, Pangrobinson as property package, and then we will move to the simulation environment. So accordingly, here methane and water will be selected, and we will click on this next, or we can directly go to the methods and select Pangrobinson, and accordingly we will click on the run, and once results are available over here, we will move to the simulation environment. And in this simulation environment, in the exchangers, this is the number third one. We have already done heater, we have already done MHEX, and now it's time to do the MHEX, multi-stream heat exchanger, model LNG exchangers, cold box. It is actually called as a cold box for the processes. Now this is the heat exchanger which is installed over here, and accordingly we will do the connections over here. Now you can see this one is the hot feed, optional, one or more. This is the cold feed, optional, one or more. This is cold product, optional one for every cold feed. Obviously, if you have two feeds, obviously you will have two products. Three feeds, three products. Similarly, for this one, hot product optional, one for every hot feed. And these are the decant water for accordingly hot and for cold here. So accordingly, we know that we have two hot streams. So we will label it as this one is as F1, this one as F2. Accordingly, we will select the same nomenclature that we have used F3, this one as F4. So this is currently, this is the same combination as that of this ETEX, that we have one hot inlet, one cold inlet, one hot outlet and one cold outlet. But now in our this process, we have two hot inlets. So accordingly, what we will do, we will connect it over here. And accordingly, this should have some outlet specification as well. And if I extend it a bit to make it aligned, to ensure that it is properly aligned streams, and accordingly like this one, and control E, control B to align these, then we will move it over here and like this one as well, and like this one to ensure that it is the proper streams. Control A, control B, and click on this to get back to the system. Now we have to specify F1, and F1 is at 50 degrees centigrade, 2 bar, 100 kg mole per hour with a mole fraction of methane as 1. Similarly, specifying for F5, which is the second hot inlet stream, 50 degree centigrade, 2 bar, 100 kg mole per hour and mole fraction of methane as 1. Now going to this F2, which is the hot cold stream, 25 degree centigrade, 2 bar, mole flow rate of 1000 kg mole per hour and mole fraction of water as 1. Now you have specified the material streams, and now you have to go to this MHEX block. Now first it requires is the outlet streams. So F1 outlet stream is F4, as you can see over here. You can make it as F6 as well, because currently it's up to you. But once you have specified, you have to stick to it. So accordingly, align accordingly in the picture so that you remember once you are dealing with the complex diagrams. And accordingly, F2 is linked with F3, only one option is available because you have connected with the cold side, and accordingly this one is F6. Now valid phases are vapor liquid for all of these, and you have to give the specification. This one, look at this temperature, vapor fraction, temperature change, these are this almost same values or same requirements as that of the heat X. So click on this temperature and specify it as 30 degree centigrade. Accordingly, you have to click here, not here, because this one is for cold and this one is for hot, and 30 degree centigrade. And now you can see required input is complete, but we have to specify the pressure drop as well. Scroll it down. This one is pressure 000. Currently, it means that the inlet and outlet pressures are same. But we know that there is a pressure drop of 0.1 bar at hot sides for both, and for cold side is 0.2 bar. So accordingly, now run the process, and once you run it, you will get the required results. And now results are available. Go to here, to the block results, and now you can see that F1 to F4, F5 to F6 and F2 to F3. First two streams are hot stream, third one is the cold stream. From 50 to 30 degree centigrade, inlet pressure 2 bar to outlet pressure 1.9 bar for both. The change will be observed on the cold side because it will be calculated while these are the specified values, 25 to 26.788 degree centigrade. And the total duty for the process heat exchange is 40.4001. while 20.2 is exchanged from here and 20.2 is exchanged from this side. Again, the balance, it will be the same as that of the previous. And for the exchanger, total duty is, if we take it to kilowatt, is 40.4001. And now if you go to the stream results, you can also see the stream results over here, which are present in detail over here. So that's how you simulate the multi-stream heat exchanger in Aspen Plus. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos on this channel.